evening, everyone. My name is Julia Davids, and I want to welcome you here tonight for this wonderful celebration of the teaching legacy of Terry Schaffner Emmerich. What can we say about Terry? Lots of things will be said, but for me, as someone who came in 13 years ago now, Terry has been an absolutely strong advocate and mentor and guide, and just a guiding light in what I do here at Earth Park. She's taught me to stand up for students, how to walk alongside them, how to push when you need to, and how to be kind and nurturing and a genuine colleague and an inspiring educator. So I'm not going to go on and on because we have an incredible program here tonight. A huge thanks to all of the performers this evening. I know that you are here because of your love for Terry and because of your regard for her, and that means a lot to all of us. So thank you for coming, enjoy the evening, and let's have a joyous celebration of Terry.
Have reached where I am right now. And I also want to thank you for your inspiration in my life and your mentorship. So thank you so much for everything you did for me when I was a student at North Park. I also want to say congratulations on your amazing career, and I'm very excited for you for the next chapter of your life. So here's a little musical greeting for you.
Thank you. So I give you all perspective on Terry's relationship with North Park and all of you who have studied with her in the past, her colleagues and students. And that's been for 35 years. She's worked very hard to achieve her own goals, as most of you know if you've worked with her. And while she was getting her own education, she has told me she felt many people had more innate talent than she did. And I don't think anyone ever worked harder. And she's been pretty successful, as she's a professor of music here for 35 years. She is was with the Chicago Symphony for 27 years, with Music of the Broke, and she's now with the Milwaukee Symphony. So she's been pretty good for someone who's an underachiever. And she began her music, professional music career at age 13 when she became a church keyboardist. So you know now why she's always pushed her own students and her colleagues, because she knows if you work hard enough, it pays off. And I think most of you who work with her do see that in her. I'm sure you do. What you may not know, though, is what a huge part of her life, North Park, has been. Those of you who are here and colleagues and students from the past, how much it's meant to her. And she would never tell you this, of course, so I have to. I think it's given her an enormous sense of satisfaction and a sense of worth and success. And when things are good here, she's happy. When they're not, not so much.
might not speak, I thought I'd just give you a little one-line or two so you know what you're going to hear. It's from an opera that's very rarely done, but this wonderful music at the end of the piece, the character is feeling somewhat philosophical about the events of the day, and he says, "How beautiful is music, but even more beautiful when it is over." Sheds a little light on why I might have chosen this piece for this occasion. Now rest, now rest.
Thank you. Thank you. Music, Art, and Theater for giving me the tremendous honor of speaking tonight. It has been my privilege to know Terry since 1997. And I get fortune to now call her a colleague and friend. I'm grateful to be able to reflect this evening on being Terry's student. The day that I auditioned at North Park, I was so nervous, but things were going well until I hit the ending of Bach's Italian Concerto in F major. To my complete horror, I reached the last notes, and they were gone. The chord disappeared, and a spoiler alert, it was an F major chord.
It's not
not all sunshine and rainbows and butterflies. Terry is not afraid to tell you if you're wrong or that you messed up. She's not a coddler, and you will work hard. You will nail those passages and rhythms because Terry expects that. Her ability to hold extremely high expectations and care for students is one of the reasons why so many of us found the paths in music that we did, and why we are able to continue to walk those paths today. Terry is bold and confident, and that has always been one of the things that I like the most about her. She is fearless, unflappable, right, Michael? Unflappable, or she sure seems that way. But for many young women at North Park, Terry has been such a great example of what it means to be intelligent, professional, and to take no guff. No guff. What a gift for all the students who weren't quite sure how to handle ourselves yet. We had Terry to shed a little light on the path. The same day that I auditioned at North Park, I ran into a friend of my older brother before I left campus. This young man was already in the music department, and he asked if I had gotten to meet Terry. She's a really bright light in that department, he said, wise beyond his years. And so she was, and she still shall be, for about 12 more weeks. But who's counting? Terry, as we gather tonight to celebrate your amazing career at North Park, it is my deepest wish that your retirement be filled with as much travel as your credit card will bear, as much gardening as your back allows, as much delicious food and wine as your waistband permits, and more laughter than you could ever have fathomed. May we, your former students, your friends and colleagues, continue the amazing legacy that you began when you first set foot on this campus so many years ago. Thank you so very much. We love you.
Thank you. Catching the rain. Trumpet Song. From the very delicate braided hair of you, I would like to make a chain so that I can bring you to my side. And I want to become a pitcher in your house. Why? Because that way I can kiss you whenever you drink water. By the way, does anybody drink water from a pitcher? Go back to their song. A tiny bride, a tiny bridegroom, a tiny room, a tiny
I love Debussy. And this one, I'll put it this way, it's been played at many transitions in life. And here we are, I'm having a transition. Thank you.
So thank you so much. My heart really is full of gratitude. I'm just really overflowing right now for my faculty members, Dr. Davids, I don't need to call you Dr. Davids, Julia, Joe Lill, Yu Song, Michael McBride's not here, Tom Zell had the lead. This is an amazing faculty. I'm really going to miss them a lot. But don't ever count me out. You don't know. I may be back, and I am going to be at least till the end of the semester. We need to get this piano moved. No. The guys are going to do it. No, I mean, that was part of the show. And I forgot to bring them on stage. So I just want to thank my wonderful family. I want to point them out. My brother, retired colonel in the Air Force, civilian general in the Corps. I think I said it kind of weird. And he's still working. My sister was director of 4-H in South Carolina. She has a doctorate in higher ed. She worked for Clemson, unfortunately, many, many years in their programs. So I do want to say one thing, though. This will bring it all circle. So when one day, when we were having a lesson, Melissa and I, she brought Fiona, her young daughter. Delightful, brilliant red hair, just as beautiful as her mom is. And so she was well behaved, but at some point I could see she's getting a little itchy. So I said, well, Fiona, what do you think about how do you think things are going? She says, I think mom's teaching you a lot. All the time about life. So for the future of the world, you need to pursue what's inside you, and they have all pursued it. So love you all. Now, here comes the fun part.
Thank you.